Jag är så exalterad. Vi har en äkta, riktig stjärna direkt från Hollywood med glamour så ryker i öronen på besök idag. Ingen mindre än Kat Von D som många av er har sett i tv-serien LA Inc. bland annat.
Ja, och det är nog aldrig... Alltså, ni som är med i tatueringsvärlden, ni vet vad vi pratar om. Och ni som inte är det, ni ska veta att här har vi tatuerarnas Rembrandt. Hon är så bra på nyanser, svartvitt. Hon är så bra på porträtt och har förändrat tatueringskonsten.
Och detta är hennes nya bok som hon är i Sverige för att lansera.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good. I have no idea what you said, but it sounds good.
Yeah, only nice just... things.
Okay,
only
good.
Nice. We upped you. Yeah. So, welcome to Sweden. Isn't it incredibly cold and don't you want to go back to
LA? No, not at all. Everybody keeps apologizing for the weather, but I actually am a big fan of this weather, so... And I've been to Sweden many times, and so I love it here.
But we were saying that really LA is much better venue for tattoos than here. You have to cover up all the time because it's so cold.
Yeah, I mean, I think that tattooing, well, for me personally, is a very intimate thing. You know, I get, even though it's an external form of self-expression, it is, I get tattooed for myself. So, you know, whether I have a jacket on or not, I know that they're there.
Okej. Okay. Hon säger att tatueringen är faktiskt en mer en intim sak, någonting för en själv och inte så mycket för att bara visa. Så att det gör inte så mycket, man måste klä på sig varma kläder.
Yeah, you started tattooing when you were 14 years old. How come?
Well, I think I was always artistically inclined. My parents, I was fortunate to have very nurturing parents when it comes to art. So,
in what way?
Well, you know, they supported everything that, like, when I was drawing and, you know, I would enter these little art contests in elementary school and they would be very supportive. But I think once I started tattooing, I come from a relatively conservative background, so they were a little bit scared about the whole idea. I think there was a lot of negative stigma surrounding tattooing for so long.
But they didn't throw you out or put you on some kind of parole?
No, I think my dad was more concerned with my mohawk at the time. And I would be too, instead of my little tattoo. But now, you know, it's been, I took a decade and a TV show later and my dad is actually very proud of me. So, so it's nice. And I think I've been able to do my part and shed some positive light on the world of tattooing.
But what's your fascination about skin compared to just, you know, painting?
Well, or I mean, I love painting and I love drawing and charcoal and all kinds of different mediums. I think that I love tattooing the most because there's a connection that you share with somebody when you're tattooing them, and it's quite magical. At least for me, it is.
Did you tattoo your dad?
No, I don't think my dad will ever get a tattoo. He's a doctor and he's just not really the type to do that. But I like him the way that he is, you know. I actually have a portrait of him on me. So this is one of my favorite tattoos. That was his graduation photo.
That's brilliant. Wow. Did you do it yourself?
No. I'm right-handed.
Okay.
But yeah, when I showed it to him, he was like, oh my god, why would you get that? But then he's like, let me see it.
Vi ska bara översätta till svenska. De flesta skulle kanske säga att föräldrar kanske skulle reagera. Det gjorde även Kats föräldrar. Men de har alltid uppmuntrat hennes konstutövning. Och det var nog mohawk-frisyren som de var mer bekymrade över. Nu har hon en tatuering av sin pappa på insidan där också som en hyllning.
What are the trends right now?
I don't know. I always stay away from trends. I think it's different, you know, if you're talking about a shoe or a handbag, you know, that's, if it's out at the end of the season, you can throw it away. But with your tattoos, it's a very permanent thing. So you should probably stay away from trends.
Yeah, that's a good advice.
Yes.
Yeah, do you often meet people that you go, oh no, don't make that tattoo?
I think it's not my place to tell people what to get, but I think as a tattooer, it's our responsibility to guide people into getting something that they're not going to regret later. So, you know, in the end, that's the neat part about tattooing. It's a very collaborative experience, you know. It's not just what I want to do, it's like what the client wants and trying to find a balance.
Do you regret any of your
tattoos? No regrets at all.
And they all mean something to you?
Yeah, to a certain degree. I mean, I like getting some tattoos I get just because I like the art, you know, but that's meaning in itself.
But I was thinking, you know, when we get old and sort of the skin
gets wrinkly.
Yeah, and you know, we're all going to go into the elderly home and someone's going to change our diapers perhaps.
Sure.
And then we have this sort of
tattoo
F word tattooed on our, I mean, how is that going to affect us? Or
I don't know. I think when I'm 80 years old, the last thing I'm going to worry about is what my boobs look like. I'm just going to be happy if I can go to the bathroom by myself.
You're not only a great tattoo, you're also like a media superstar by now.
I don't know.
How would you sort of we know a lot of things about you, although we're in Sweden, that you who your boyfriends are,
really?
And that you had a terrible accident at your house burnt down. What happened?
Well, in the middle, I've been on a book tour for the past 2 months, and right in the middle of the tour, there was an electrical fire in my house, so it burned down, and I don't, you know, the stuff that's in my house, I loved it, but I'm not attached to material, so I'm not so much affected by the house, but my kitty cat was inside the house, so I think I'm more saddened by that. Yeah.
It died?
Mm-hmm.
So
then, you know, everybody's like, why didn't you cancel your tour? And I just think I could either stay home and be depressed or come out and continue my tour and meet a lot of smiling faces. And, you know, this is like my first time in Sweden where I actually get a chance to meet fans. Normally I was here on the road on tour, and so I didn't get to meet a lot of people. So it'll be good.
We've had a tattoo theme this morning, so one of our viewers sent in pictures of their own tattoos.
Cool. Well,
maybe you could just comment on what we
okay,
see
I'm not,
here.
I'm a bad critic,
there.
But...
you can see there.
Oh, this that's is, beautiful.
Yeah.
Wow, John Lennon, that's so great. Whoever did that, it did a very good job.
It could have been you.
No. I remember every tattoo I do. I didn't do that.
What's
one.
The challenge of making a portrait on someone?
Well, I think, I mean, obviously the first... First and foremost is, you know, the accuracy. You know, you want to make sure that it looks like the person. And obviously, on a portrait like that, everybody knows who that is. So that means they did a good job in that sense.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We can see some other pictures as well. Have them coming.
That's cool. Yeah. I know, right?
Fin spång, Don Andersson.
Do you work, like, with body part things sticking
that's beautiful.
Out?
And, oh, yeah. That's beautiful. I love that. I think it's a very nice composition, and all the little fine line black and gray around it. It's nice texture.
It takes weeks to do that, or
sometimes
months?
It depends. Every artist is different, you know, and something like that I could imagine taking several sessions, but...
Mm-hmm. But are there like no-nos? Would you like use a nipple as an eye or something?
I usually steer away from doing those. It tends to be kind of cheesy sometimes,
okay,
you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, to each their own.
Is it expensive?
I think it depends, you know? Every artist is different, so...
You?
I'm pretty cheap.
That goes for a lot of us.
Yeah. That sounds good in Swedish.
Right?
This is yours?
Yeah, that was on Dave Navarro, actually. I don't know if you guys know who Dave Navarro is, obviously, from Jane's Addiction.
Uh-huh.
That was a portrait of his mother, who was an actress and a model back in the day. And not a lot of people know this, but his mother was murdered when he was 15 years old. And so he actually talked to me a lot about how... Even though it was a tragic situation, it inspired him to channel his energy into music. And so, I don't know, I think it's a pretty inspiring story.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do you play music yourself?
Yeah, no. I've been playing classical music since I was 6 years old, piano. Uh-huh. So I have like 4 or 5 Beethoven tattoos. Yeah, I'm a big Beethoven fan.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Were you always, because on the other one hand you're like a rebellion, but on the other hand you have this excellence in everything you do.
Oh, thank you. I'm not really that much of a rebel, you know. I'm really close to my family and stuff, so I'm not that much of a rebel type. This was a rendition of Doré's Paradise Lost, and that was I think 13 hours worth of work. So it's one of my favorite tattoos I've ever done. There's so many layers in that.
Wow. Are you going to tattoo in Sweden now as well?
Oh, I wish I had time, you know, but...
You will not.
No, I'd rather talk to you guys.
Yeah. Thanks for that.
Oh. This is beautiful.
Yeah, we did an angel. Nikki, actually, he's a really great photographer, and he took a picture of a statue in Italy, and we made it into a tattoo. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's your boyfriend as well, right?
My ex-boyfriend.
Your
yes.
ex-boyfriend.
Yeah,
okay. I'm not up to date.
So you get the inspiration from statues, from art, from music, from anything.
I think everything is inspiring, you know. Mm. Yeah.
Do you think that tattoos are sexy?
I think it's in the eye of the beholder, you know. I mean, I don't get tattooed to be sexy, but I think some things look sexier than others. Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you for having
thank
me, guys.
You.
It was awesome.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun talking to you.
Yes.
Vi ska
good luck with your book.
Thank you.
Lite grann, men det är väldigt bra. Det är väldigt bra.